another episode of Feel Like Dancing? Do you have your dancing shoes on? Because we feel like dancing. Last week, we began our first out of our five cultural dances, the Takiki dance. And this week, we will be doing something much closer to home, a Malay cultural dance. Let's go! Malay dance has a wide variation and heavily influenced by several cultural practices and traditional elements such as martial arts, humor, and storytelling. Most traditional Malay dances are also influenced by India, Java, and other parts of Southeast Asia. Its genres range from traditional Malay folk dance and drama like Mak Yong to the Arab-influenced Zapin dance. Joget is another popular traditional Malay dance. It is lively with an upbeat tempo. Is performed by couples with a fast graceful movement and a little humor. Today we learn one of this.
Hi, my name is Awalia Jaafar and I'm from Kiran Anthony, one of the Malay dance group in Singapore, and I've been dancing for about 15 years.
My name is Chloe and this is Maya.
Hi Chloe, hi Maya.
So, can you tell us what dances we're doing today?
Today, I'm going to share with you four basic Malay dances. I'm going to teach you Asli, Inang, Zapin and Joget.
So, where do these dances originate from?
Maybe I would like to share Zapin. Zapin, where do you think Zapin comes from?
Malaysia?
Okay, actually, Zapin comes from Saudi Arabia, or the exact location is called Yemen. And do you know that once upon a time, only males are allowed to dance Zapin?
So, why do you still do Malay dance?
One, it's passion. Two, and if I don't share or practice my own culture, who's gonna do it, right?
True. So, during the dances, do they have any meanings?
How about, let me share Serampang 12. Serampang 12 is actually a joget dance, and it's actually a 12-step dance. It starts from how the girl and boy first met, love at first sight, to courting, and then, and of course, ending up with getting married.
Yeah. That's interesting. It is. So, what is the most important thing to remember while doing a Malay dance?
Everything. From the hands to the leg to your smile and also your eyes.
Are they popular with the young generation?
At the moment, we still have young kids practicing Malay dance. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess in CCAs and all, right?
Yeah.
So shall we get to the dancing?
Yes, why not?
Let's go.
Okay, so first I want you to stand back. Okay, we are going to do one by one. You are going to stand first and then you. So you put your hands together. Okay. So your left leg put cross and you turn. Okay, very simple. Okay, let's do it together. 5, 6, 7, go. Up. Look to the left. And back and left. Right hand on shoulder and go. Back and look at the boys. Back and look at the boys. 2, cross. Again. And cross.
How do you feel about Malay dance?
I'm really excited to perform this dance piece. Malay dance is very interesting and requires a lot of grace,
which I don't have. I do need a lot of practice.
So, you ready for the performance?
I'll try.
Let's dance! Thank you.
me feel more of a girl and less than a tomboy. That was such a fun experience. If you enjoyed watching us, keep watching because we're going to do something else that's fun, cultural, and new. See you next time for more Feel Like Dancing!